This is the SAP Developer News for February 29th, 2024.
Hello, everyone. SAP BTP ABAP Environment Release 2402 was delivered to our Steampunk customers on February 17, 2024. This particular release features highlights such as bring your own Git capability, support for enterprise search, and data replication from ABAP. Most of these features were directly requested by our premium customers and are therefore important milestones and key features for our customers and partners. The details of the new features from this release are explained in this blog post by Florian Ball. He explains about bring your own Git for the ABAP environment in BTP, enterprise search support in CDS-based search models via annotations, data replication with ABAP as a source, updates on SOAP provider model and ABAP development tools. ABAP RESTful application programming model updates include definition of static and instance feature control for fields and support for generating custom OData UI services based on wrapped BO interfaces. The blog post lists new features in administration and operation topic, continuous integration and delivery, infrastructure support for elastic scaling of application servers, and finally, updates on integration and connectivity topic. All the sections in this blog post have further links to topic details. You can find the link to the blog post in the description below.
Did you know? You can configure the ABAP editor in ADT to allow you to wrap and escape text when pasting into a string literal. For example, with the setting turned off, I paste my JSON code here, and of course, it puts the string on separate lines without quotes. If I enable this feature under preferences and go back and paste my JSON string again, you can see the editor will now wrap the text nicely and insert quotes on each line. Perfect.
Hello, ABAP developers. Bring your own Git. Yes, you heard it right. Well, until now, the ABAP repositories in the SAP BTP ABAP environment aka Steampunk were managed by the Managed Software Components Fiori app, which was the only interface where a user could see the status of their remote repository. Bring your own Git allows users to connect their own Git repositories with the Managed Software Components app. This is available from the 2402 release of the SAP BTP ABAP environment. Christoph explains in this blog post how to create and clone new software component, creating branches, still use a transport and pull in the target system. One point to note is the fingerprint.json file that is written for every transported object. It contains fingerprints which will be validated in the target system during pull from Git. This will ensure commits pushed from the ABAP system can be pulled only to the dedicated target systems. For more information on how to leverage this, check the blog post in the description below.
Hello, everyone. A current recommendation for creating value helps in ABAP Cloud involves custom CDS views based on customer domain value and its text views. However, this approach has few drawbacks, including the need for dedicated CDS views for each domain and limited functionality for domains in customer-owned software components. In response to a forum question, Andre Fisher created a blog post explaining an alternative solution using a single custom entity using runtime type information or RTTI to retrieve domain fixed values. To address the challenge of providing the domain name for the value held that may arise in this approach, we can utilize the local constant keyword along with setting the usage parameter to hash filter. By doing this, the coding can specify the domain's name whose fixed values should be used. It's crucial to note that this approach won't work if the element such as domain underscore name is hidden in the value held CDS view, for example, through UI hidden true. You can also find the technicality of query implementation class in the blog post Fetching Text for Domain Fixed Values by Michael Badura within the SAP community. You may also use the XCO library to achieve the same results. Thank you.
Hola, SAP developers. In case you missed it, recently, there were some enhancements in the SAP BTP cockpit, which will increase the transparency and traceability of your usage. We can now activate to see the commercial information for each service in the Entitlement Services page. When activated, it will show you information like the entitlement source, license quantity, and commercial type. Also, this information can be seen when adding new services to your sub-account. The Usage Analytics page has been renamed to Costs and Usage, introducing a new UI and some new capabilities. For example, we can now view our billing by service and also by directory sub-account structure. Also, we can use the Advanced Usage View to continually monitor usage and resource consumption. And before I finish, I just want to remind you that you can influence the future of SAP products. For this, check out the Customer Engagement Initiatives projects at influence.sap.com. For example, maybe you're interested in improving the admin experience of the SAP BTP cockpit, or you want to share your insights on how you engage with the SAP Discovery Center. I'm including the links in the description below.
Hi there. If you have watched my tech bite about prompting the generative AI hub on SAP AI Core using SAP AI Launchpad, you might wonder how you're supposed to develop more sophisticated use cases like retrieval augmented generation for question answering or agent orchestration or training large language models. Well, for all the Python lovers out there, I have good news. The Python SDK for the generative AI hub has been released. The website already has some cool examples. And if you're familiar with the Python SDK for SAP AI Core, you will have absolutely no problems using this one. My colleague Drup also extended his tutorial, Prompt LLMs in the Generative AI Hub in SAP AI Core and Launchpad, to include more examples of how to use the Python SDK. I also wanted to highlight a cool blog post by Andreas Roth that gives you a better understanding of the features and capabilities of the Generative AI Hub, and all the information is, as always, linked in the description.